Benghazi, Libya, September 11th, 2012. On the 11th anniversary of the most devastating terrorist attack in U.S. history. The United States consulate is overrun by militant rebels and set ablaze. American Ambassador Christopher Stevens and three diplomatic aides are murdered. The following morning, President Barack Obama gives a statement in the Rose Garden condemning the attacks and vowing to bring the perpetrators to justice.
Make no mistake, we will work with the Libyan government to bring to justice the killers who attacked our people.
The attack in Libya appears to be a very coordinated military-style attack. This was not a demonstration gone bad.
5 days later, United Nations Ambassador Susan Rice appears on five Sunday talk shows and blames the attack on a spontaneous reaction to an anti-Muslim YouTube video.
What sparked the recent violence was the airing on the internet of a very hateful, very offensive video.
But when intelligence reports later indicate that the president and his staff had earlier evidence that the attack was the work of Al-Qaeda, questions begin to be asked. Was the American public being told the truth?
After the embassy was attacked in Benghazi, a lot of people questioned what the White House knew and when they knew it.
Some claim that the terrorist attack was covered up by the Obama administration. Now, why would the Obama administration want to cover this up? This attack occurred right before a presidential election. The last thing the Obama administration would want would be embarrassing information coming out on the eve of the election.
They blame a YouTube video for sparking the attack. The Al-Qaeda terrorists took responsibility for it.
Clearly were intelligence failures. There clearly was great confusion about what had happened.
The administration made a mistake. They did not have sufficient security. People said we need more security, they didn't get it.
Could the murders have been prevented? And why was President Obama reluctant to blame Al-Qaeda?
The U.S. consulate had asked for multiple rounds of security, was denied it. The cover-up part comes in when the administration is campaigning on the idea that Al-Qaeda is no longer a threat to the United States.
The goal of the Benghazi September 11th assassinations was to embarrass Obama, to refute his contention that Al-Qaeda was defeated. Al-Qaeda, of course, is not defeated.
Well, the Vice President of the United States told the American people that it was an intelligence failure, that they had been told that the YouTube video had sparked the attack.
Did the Obama administration really conceal Al-Qaeda's involvement in the attack on the U.S. consulate for fear it would undermine the president's bid for re-election? Or was there another, perhaps even more secret reason for the administration's reluctance to admit the truth?
A president would justify a cover-up if national security was at stake, but the problem comes in when is the national security at stake? And I think presidents are very elastic about that.
There are some who believe the attack in Benghazi was at the center of an even greater presidential cover-up, one involving a secret CIA outpost located approximately a mile from the U.S. consulate.
When President Obama came into office, he immediately signed an executive order stopping what they call enhanced interrogation, torture, at CIA facilities overseas. What came up in the Benghazi cover-up is that the CIA was actually holding prisoners in the consulate in Benghazi, which maybe was a reason why there was an attack.
Apparently, the compound in Benghazi was not really a consulate. Many believe it was primarily a CIA operation, and nobody exactly knows what the CIA was doing in Benghazi and whether CIA activities were involved with sparking this terrorist attack on the compound.
Is it possible that the CIA facility near the Benghazi consulate was the real target of the Al-Qaeda attack on September 11th? If so, why was the compound involved in covert operations? And is this the secret being covered up by the White House?
Some have speculated that the CIA in Libya was recruiting rebel fighters. In other words, if there is a cover-up with respect to Benghazi, it likely comes from the CIA and is still ongoing. Ambassador Stevens had his last meeting with a Turkish diplomat. Now, why would the U.S. ambassador be meeting a Turkish diplomat in the terror capital of Libya? The CIA was in Benghazi to direct the shipment of weaponry from Gaddafi's arms depot and guerrilla fighters to Turkey so those could be sent into Syria to overthrow Assad. The embarrassing thing about this, of course, for the Obama administration is that they are caught doing this.
Is the U.S. involved with any procuring of weapons, transfer of weapons, buying, selling, anyhow transferring weapons to Turkey out of Libya?
To Turkey? I do not know.
Concerning the attack on the U.S. consulate and CIA post in Benghazi, Libya, the attempt to pin this on Obama is pure big lie propaganda. CIA asset kills ambassador, CIA assets run away. That's nothing to do with Obama. It has to do with the CIA.
Everything goes back to the president in the United States. So what his cabinet does, what his department does, what the departments within the federal government do, eventually is his responsibility.
Was the attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi perpetrated by Al-Qaeda operatives who had been secretly working with the CIA? And is this the reason why the Obama administration was quick to blame the attack on a 15-minute YouTube video?
After Benghazi and around the time of the election, a whole series of top admirals and generals get fired. Petraeus is out, General Allen, Admiral Stavridis at NATO, the head of the Missile Defense Agency, General Carter Ham, the head of U.S. Africa. There's a whole series of high-profile careers that mysteriously come to an end in the autumn of 2012, and nobody has come up with a satisfactory explanation. The public has not been told the entire truth.
Are the details of the attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi really part of a presidential cover-up? And if so, is it to protect American interests and national security? Or is the reason purely political?
Most cover-ups are for a presidential gain or to protect the president, either personally or politically.
All governments like to operate in secret. Whether you come in as a liberal or conservative, once you're in power, you seem to prefer to operate in the shadows or secretly.
There's a great temptation to think, I have to